Hello, everybody. Welcome. What a absolutely beautiful morning it is here at Disney's Animal Kingdom. I am so excited to be here. Usually we come in the evening hours. We finally got over here on a weekend morning because we want to check out all the new things, all the new characters. Everything that sort of disappears in the evening hours, we're finally going to get a look at today. A lot of stuff going on for the 25th anniversary of Animal Kingdom, so I couldn't be more excited. Let's get going. It is just such a different energy in the mornings, I feel like.
Yeah.
We're always here in the evening hours. Very rarely come in the mornings or afternoons, and it's just so different. Like, just the music that's playing, the energy, it's just a different vibe, I think, in the mornings, for sure. And I kind of miss it. It kind of reminds me of when we used to, like, rope drop stuff early in the mornings when we would come here on vacation. Now that we live here and we come here all the time, especially in the evening hours, we don't get to experience it this way, and it's just totally different. Big reasons that I wanted to come here so early today is because a lot of the character interactions, a lot of the little daytime shows and things that happen, they all stop around 5 o'clock. So we never get to see them. And I really want to see if we can catch some of the shows today. So we're going to try and catch some of the shows, see if we can get some of the character interactions that we haven't got to see. There's new character interactions for the 25th anniversary. So we're going to see what we can find. You can see the bird shows going on up here. Look at all the birds. Bird show in so long. That's so cool. All those, like, macaws, or I don't even know what they are. She said what they were and I've already forgotten. But they're so cool, like flying over you. If you're not prepared for it, it's like, what's going on? It's so cool. I haven't seen that in a while. I think we're gonna ride the dinosaur ride. don't think there's very... Doesn't look like there's a long wait for it.
No.
Yeah, look, it's only a 5-minute wait. I mean, there's usually not a long wait for this ride, but sometimes it does get kind of long and it goes like all the way back there. But there's only a 5-minute wait right now, so we're in business.
Hello. I'm Dr. Marsh, director of the Dino Institute, and I hope you enjoyed those quaint exhibits in the old wing. That's how dinosaurs have been presented to the public since the study of fossils began over 150 years ago. Today, that bare bones approach is about to become extinct. In a perfect blending of science and technology, the Dino Institute has created the Time Rover, an amazing vehicle that will literally transport you to the age of the dinosaurs. How? That's proprietary. But the result is a breathtaking journey through a prehistoric world where you will witness the most spectacular creatures to ever walk the earth. In a moment, you'll be going live to our control center for a comprehensive safety briefing, and then it's on to the tour that will convince you forever that the future is truly in the past.
Hello there. Welcome to our little trans-dimensional joyride, folks. I'm Dr. Seeker, your friendly controller, and a heck of a paleontologist, if I do say so myself. But let's not talk about me, let's talk about you, and how you can help me make history today with the Time Rover. It's like this. If I can bring you back from the Cretaceous period, it stands to reason that I can bring back a live dinosaur with you. And not just any dinosaur. Take a look at this guy. He's an iguanodon, and I'm certain that he is the key to understanding these magnificent creatures.
I tagged him with a locator during an unauthorized field trip. Otherwise, I'd be traveling with you. Right now, our dino should be about here, at the very end of the Cretaceous period. That's where you're going today.
I've arrived, it seems, just in time to correct a little misstatement.
Dr. Marsh.
That is impossibly close to the giant asteroid impact that destroyed most life forms on Earth. Our tours are designed to take you to the early Cretaceous period, and I can assure you that all time rovers have been securely locked on those coordinates.
That's right. See?
Securely locked. Access denied.
Continue.
Of course. We were just talking about seatbelts. Plug them in. Use them. It can get kind of choppy out there, so keep your hands and arms inside the vehicle at all times.
Flash photography? I wouldn't. It alters the homing signal, and that's not good. Oh, and one more thing. Those locked coordinates? We're in. Now, here's the drill. You follow the homing signal to the iguanodon, then I'll enlarge the transport field, and boom, you're back with one additional passenger extra large. And don't worry about that asteroid. You'll be in and out of there before it even breaks the atmosphere. Trust me, what could go wrong? Hey.
Wow, they actually have something new here at Dinosaur that they never had before. Check out the back of the car right there. See that contraption on the back? It looks like it has like speakers and maybe lights or something on it. That's new. That's not been there before. You can see they kind of like bolted them on right there. But they've never, that's not been there before. Those are new additions to the vehicles. I'm curious if it's going to make a difference, if what it, you know, what the difference is, what it's going to do.
Commencing in T-minus 10 seconds and counting.
This is Seeker. Listen up. We've got to get in, grab the iguanodon, and get out before that asteroid hits. Let's roll!
Let's go get that dino. Computer, what are you tracking?
Styracosaurus.
Not our dino.
Warning, meteor shower in range.
Just little one.
Olearamus. Hadrosaur. Raptor.
Time to get serious. Locking autopilot on homing signal now! Hang on! I'm tracking a big dino on the scope. Could be ours. Computer, full stop. Identify.
Carnotaurus.
Definitely not our dino. Go, go, go! Another big guy coming up. Computer, slow and identify.
Sauropod.
Still not our dino, but at least this one's a vegetarian.
Asteroid impact in 90 seconds.
We better move it.
Pterodactyl.
Incoming!
Asteroid impact in 60 seconds.
We can't stop now. Keep going, keep going.
Compsognathus.
Computer, what's happening?
Loss of traction.
Four-wheel drive, move it!
Warning, meteor strike.
Evasive maneuver, left, right, left, right! That was close. Computer, now what?
Carnotaurus.
That's it. Abort mission. Abort! Abort!
Iguanodon.
Forget it! Get them out now!
Asteroid impact.
Brace yourself! This is it! They're not gonna make it! They're not gonna make it!
Mission accomplished.
You made it! I knew you would, and guess who made it back with you? I better find it before security does. Thanks for everything!
Was it just me, or was that whole ride weird?
Please gather personal belongings from the house.
Yeah, it was weird the whole time. Something was weird. Well, I love that ride, Dinosaur, but something was weird.
Yeah.
Something was off. The sound... music, I don't know what it was, but something was weird. I don't know what those things are on the back that they added, but I didn't see it do anything new. I didn't see any like special new lighting. The sound was weird and off. It was still coming from the front speakers, but like something was missing. Something was off. I can't put my finger on it. So whatever those things are in the back of the car, they made it worse, I guess. Or else maybe they're just not working yet. I don't know what the deal is, but something's weird. Next time you ride Dinosaur, let me know. Let us know if you think the same thing. If you notice anything's different or if it seems exactly the same, I don't know. Something was odd. It was weird. Look, we got Dino Bash. We have Donald from the Dino Bash. Look how cute Donald is. He's shaking his butt. Cute. I see one of the little musical barges out there in the lagoon. I see Timon and Rafiki out there. Pretty far away over there, though. I wonder if they're going to move over. If they're going to come over here. I don't see any alligators at the moment. So, no. They're probably in there. Hey, it's getting closer. Oh, there's another one coming.
Greetings, fellow wilderness explorers. Great news! Russell and Doug have successfully spotted their feathered friend, Kevin. Now, just like you.
And now, marine life enthusiasts, come with us as we explore the mysterious world of the open ocean.
Hey Dad, wouldn't it be cool if I maybe met a shark when I'm in school?
No.
Or an angel fish, is it true that they have wings?
It's time for you to arrive.
Let's name the zones. Let's name the zones of the open sea.
Mr. Red!
Come aboard, explorers! Oh, who's this?
I'm Nemo.
He's got a little. We call it his lucky fins. Now, if he gets tired, give him a break. 10 feet.
He'll be all right.
Let's go, explorers. Hold
We got to see Finding Nemo, the big blue beyond, for the first time since COVID. I'm so excited. I loved it. It was so good. We never get to see any of the shows because they're all, they don't run. They don't run during the evening hours. So made it over there. We got to watch it. I love that show. What does everybody else think? I still think the original version is better, but it's still good. I think the show being a little bit shorter is good for, I think, people with like small children or maybe don't want to sit there for a long period of time. I really miss the go with the flow at the end though, during like all the bows and stuff, when all the performers are coming out and doing their bows. They would redo kind of like a quick version of go with the flow, and it just sort of like tops off the whole show and ends on a really nice crescendo. That was missing, so a little bit disappointing. Again, overall amazing show, not as good as it used to be, but still worth seeing.
So we're gonna go see who we can find. The first time we ever went through this Gorilla Falls Trail, we got off of the safari and we were walking through with his sister and brother-in-law, so my sister-in-law and brother-in-law. And we were like, my brother-in-law was like, are there gonna be any gorillas on the Gorilla Falls Trail? So for some reason, you know how catchphrases or sayings just catch and you say that for the rest of your lives? That was one of them. So anytime there's not something you wanna see that you're supposed to see, we say, that. Are there going to be any gorillas on Gorilla Falls Trail? So hopefully we'll see gorillas.
Check out this termite mound. Obviously it's made out of, it's like a fake termite mound. It's probably made out of like concrete or whatever, but it's designed to show you like what the inside of a termite mound looks like and how it's like got all these like little rooms and like, look at that, there's like a cathedral in there. Probably an amphitheater right there. But it's like cool, it's seriously, it's like all sorts of like cool things. Now, this is probably, like I said, made out of some sort of like concrete, but termite mounds actually are this hard. They're so firm and hard, almost like concrete, that elephants can rub themselves and itch their backs and things on an actual termite mound and it won't get destroyed. Because I guess something to do with the way the termites saliva or whatever it is, they have some sort of like thing that they spit out and they combine it with like the mud and the dirt and it turns into basically like concrete. And here's like a little diagram, a little bit of information. Fortress City and Underground Garden. It's got circulation ducts, food storage down here at the bottom, nurseries, royal chamber house. It's pretty cool. Beware of buffalo. While walking the trail, please no eating. That's interesting. I don't think I've ever noticed that sign before. I guess you're allowed to drink though, luckily. It says no eating, did you see it? Right. Thankfully, this animal trail is not the one with the bats. I'm cool on the bats, so we are in luck. Ooh, I haven't been in this building to really explore it in a while because, yeah. There was a hedgehog in here one time. We haven't got to do this in a long time because usually when we come through here at nighttime, this area is closed. So you basically walk through it, but you can't actually come over here and look at anything. Ooh, look at these naked mole rats. Ooh, they're gross.
They're really not. They're really not cute.
Uh-huh.
You think they're cute?
Yeah.
Wow. I guess.
Look at this turtle's little leg. It's all sprawled out. Ooh, sick. There's an emperor scorpion down there. Ooh. There's a couple snakes in here. It says there's a boa. These are boa constrictors. Can't really get a good view though.
And this guy going through here giving a tour. He's got like a microphone. He's basically, everyone has little earphones in, you can notice, that are on this tour. So they can hear everything that he's saying as they're walking.
Well, this waterfall behind me makes for a really picturesque backdrop, but it's also probably really loud, so I don't even know if you can hear me talking. But I did want to talk a little bit more about that tour that we just saw going by. That's the Wild Africa Trek, which is a VIP tour. It's a 3-hour guided tour. It's $199. Yeah, it's a 3-hour tour. Yeah, it's a good one. It's $199 per person for a 3-hour guided tour throughout the different animal areas here in Animal Kingdom. You also do get some food. So it includes like food and beverages and things along the way, some like snacks and stuff. So also free complimentary photography and photos during your VIP tour. So $199 for 3 hours. I don't think that's too bad for a nice kind of private guided tour through the Animal Kingdom Reserve area.
Let's go into the hippo pool. So let's see if we actually get to see a hippo or not. Oh, I see one. Yeah, I see a few here. Oh, wow. It really does. Wow, there he is. Or she, her, him or her, or... Honestly, it's almost hard for me to focus on the hippo because it smells so bad in here.
It smells so bad in here. It's awful. I don't know. I'm leaving.
For some unknown reason, it smells like someone went to the bathroom in here, and I don't know why. Maybe it's hippo bathroom, but it's really bad. We can see the hippo's hump. That's the only part of the hippo out of the water.
Okay, that's about all the footage I could get in there. It smelled so bad in there, I had to get out. Woo, it was rough. It really smelled bad. I don't know what that was. It's never smelled like that in there before. That's the first time.
Okay, so there's meerkats and zebras back here. Let's see if we actually see any. I don't see any zebras at the moment, but I'm sure the meerkats will pop their heads out any time here. No, not yet. Did you see any yet?
Nope.
No. Well, the meerkats and the zebras were a no-show, so we're gonna move on to the gorillas. Ooh, I already see a gorilla, good. So we weren't stomped out here for the gorillas. Oh, there's another mom and a baby? What do we got? Hey, there's a couple over there. And there's some hanging out right here by the window. Oh, look, there's a little baby. I think the baby's sleeping. Cute. Like every time we come here, there's a baby. Take how cute this little baby is down here.
See if I can get his face. Look at it.
Cute. She's getting her grub on. Also, your food looks very dusty. It looks like the worst food ever. I don't think that hay is that? That's not their food, is it? I think that's like bedding. I think the green stuff is their food. There's like a piece of lettuce right there. That's probably their actual food. There we go. This one's got the food. Oh wait, he's picking the baby up. So wake up, baby. Time to get up. he just like slumped. It's like, I don't want to get up, Mom. I'm tired. I don't want to go to school. Yeah, see this one, there's the food. See, that one's got the food. I don't think that hay was their food. It was just their bedding. Cute. Gosh, went up there to get some food. Oh, he peed on Mom's back. Ain't that how it is? Man, that's legit right there. I don't know about you, but I totally felt that pee on that Mom's back. Our kids. That's how it is. As soon as you take that diaper off, boop, all over. I remember those days. Way out here is where the adult males are hanging out. Must be feeding time because they're all eating. And he's big. You can't tell on the video, but he is big. Candi was waving to the gorilla. That gorilla over there is swamp. Straight up swamp in the shade, chilling. Look who's hanging out back here. Daisy's Designs. Cute. Look at her. Look at her fit. She's not messing around, is she? Cute.
Look out, Daisy.
Cute. Check out this sweatshirt that they have. The old Magic Kingdom Electrical Parade. I don't know. I mean, I definitely don't want a sweatshirt right now. Oh my gosh, there's something on the back. Let's see. What do we got on the back of this thing? The turtle with the glasses. Ah, this sweatshirt's actually really cute. It's so hot right now, I can't even think about getting a sweatshirt, but it's super cute. And it's $49.99, which really isn't that bad.
So I saw this dress in the store as I was walking by, but we were kind of in a hurry. So I came back, I was like, I'm gonna look at a dress. And I was thinking I was probably gonna get it. See, it's super cute. It has mini on it. It has little lime green flowers, super cute. Yeah, it's just a little simple white dress that adjusts. I was thinking I was probably going to get it. No, it's $118. For what? It's not that cute, folks. It's just not that cute. Also have these mini Minnie Mouse leggings. I think they're adults. Yeah, they are. They have this little pouch, which, I don't know, they kind of look like they're for kids to me, but they are made for adults. But they kind of look kind of childish. And they have a matching sports bra. Sports bra at $78, bruh. And you know this isn't supportive? No, Disney. $78 for this. Let me see how much the leggings are. Folks, the leggings are $148.
Is this some sort of brand or something?
What? Outdoor Voices? No.
They also have this goofy version of it. It's like this like yellow or mustardy color, I guess. Also $118, so. They also have different colors of the leggings and sports bras. I'm not sure why it is so expensive, but there's a lot of them left. So, I don't know how many of them they're selling. They're pretty expensive.
Song.
Wow, what a fun day we had at Animal Kingdom. I'm so glad we actually got to come here during the daytime in the morning. It was just so different. And we got to see a lot of the performances, a lot of like character performances, shows, entertainment thing. That's just not here at night, and it was a lot of fun. We got a lot of stuff done, rode some rides, did some shopping. Overall, just a lot of fun. We didn't get to see Divine. I feel like we never see her.
I've seen her once, like a long time.
It's been a long time since we've seen her.
I don't think it's a boy or a girl.
Well, whatever it is, Divine.
The character Divine is very cute and very pretty.
Yeah, it's pretty cool, but we never get to see it. So, didn't get to see a lot of like characters walking around or anything. We saw a couple of the barges. I kind of missed that little parade they used to have during the day. That was kind of nice. But anyway, it was a lot of fun. Hope you enjoyed this episode. Be sure to tune again next time. Hit the notification so you know when it drops. Until then, the Noble Way
is the easy way.
Bye-bye, everybody.
Yeah.